Yo, what's up? Dr. Swole here with our second video in the series, Basics of Training. In this video, I'll be teaching you about progressive overload. Progressive overload can be defined as your ability to lift heavier weights in a given rep range over time. Basically, when you go to the gym and you train your muscle, you apply a stimulus that stresses the muscle and signals it to adapt. Ideally, this results in muscle growth or hypertrophy. Now in bodybuilding, I think that the best way to see that you are progressing in terms of growing muscle is to track your ability to progressively overload in the hypertrophy rep range. What that means is we should be aiming to progress over your multi-set 6 to 12 rep max. So what does that mean? Basically, over time, you should be able to lift more weight over the 6 to 12 rep range for multiple sets in an exercise. Let's go a little bit deeper into this. The reason why I say 6 to 12 rep max is because if you go below that rep range, in the 1 to 5 rep max range, you can increase your strength but not really see hypertrophy. We see this in powerlifters, where there are actually a number of lifters who can, say, deadlift 700 or more pounds, but they don't have very much muscle on them. Why is that? It's because you can train the muscle to have better neuromuscular efficiency. In other words, you can train your body to recruit muscle fibers more effectively, which allows you to lift more weight, but not necessarily get bigger. The reason I say multi-set 6 to 12 rep max is because hypertrophy is related to the total amount of volume you do over a session. Say you hit one set of 10 really hard and you set a PR for that 10 rep maximum, but the rest of your workout falls off and you use a lot less weight, fewer reps, your total volume for that session is still lower. So we'll talk a little bit more about volume later, but in terms of looking at progressive overload, we should be tracking our progress over multiple sets. Now, how do we apply progressive overload? I think the best way is to strive to add a rep, a little bit of weight, or a set with each workout or as frequently as you can. Let's say for a chest workout, you're bench pressing for 5 sets of 10 reps at 100 pounds. Say the next week you're able to do 11 reps for all of those 5 sets at 100 pounds. That would be progressive overload. Similarly, let's say you did 5 sets of 10 reps again, but with 105 pounds, that is also progressive overload. Both of those measures are probably indicating that you're gaining muscle. I would also mention that you should be seeing progressive overload over all of your exercises. So in the last example, say you progressed over your bench press, you should also be seeing progress over your other exercise. How frequently you can progress in the amount of volume you do depends on your training age. As a rank beginner, I would strongly encourage that athletes try to add a rep or an incremental amount of weight every session because they are often able to progress at this fast rate. Obviously, we want to progress as quickly as possible in the gym to get the best gains. As you find yourself getting into a more intermediate stage, you may only be able to add weight or a rep every week or every month. I would suggest that to facilitate progressive overload, you should track your reps and sets for every workout. The reason I do this is because I can look back and compare my performance to the past and even the far past, which really lets me know if I am progressing or not. The way I do this is simply by writing all my reps and sets in a notebook. You can also do this on the phone or on an Excel sheet. Lastly, I would remind you of the importance of progressive overload in our staircase of training priorities, as we talked about in the last video. Since progressive overload has so much priority at the base of the staircase, we should be thinking about it as we look at all the other training variables in our program. In other words, when you look at those other concepts, training volume, training intensity, exercise selection, you should be setting all of those other variables in a way that allows you to progressively overload as best as possible. Thanks for watching the video, guys. Make sure you subscribe, like the video, give me a comment, and we'll see you next time.